Hello everyone, it's me, Coffee Stitcher. It is the last weekend in October. It's also the last weekend day you can early vote. So if you have not voted and your state offers it, go vote. If you don't, I will be very sad. And you don't want to make me sad. So how was everybody's week? That's good. That's really good. Yummy coffee. All right. So, no haul to speak of this week. And by no haul to speak of, I mean no haul. But I do have a couple of whip updates. As well as my November plans. But we'll get to that in a little bit. And I do believe we have some Q&A. Yay, Q&A. So we will dive right on in. Haul-wise, there may be haul next week. I don't know for sure. I know Leslie's working fast and furious on Fabric of the Month. We had a very rainy October in Texas, which I know makes it more difficult for fabric dyers who have to hang things out to dry when it's pouring down rain. You can't quite do that. And I don't know if Nest Egg is going out this week or if it'll go out the week after. Yeah. I don't know a lot of things. But that's okay. All right, so let's dive in with the Q&A. I think that's still the sign for Q. All right, Crafty Curator, I love that Longfellow is what will bring you out all the time, because you are actually the one that introduced me to Longfellow's Round Tower. I think it's still going to be finished in the shape of a pillow. She said, you know, was talking about asking about my stocking. Am I going to finish it in the shape form of a stocking or more of a pillow? It'll probably still be finished as a stocking. It just won't be used as a stocking, if that makes sense. Yeah, that's kind of the plan there, I think. And it's mainly because I know several people are like, bigger stocking means more presents. Well, we don't generally do a lot of presents to begin with. We do several nice things. They'll be individually wrapped to go under the tree. But stockings, we don't really do a whole lot with. So having a stocking this big, that's just a little much. So it'll likely just be decorative. Iris Stitcher has a couple of questions. She says, I have limited exposure to hand-dyed threads living in Ireland, so I wonder, what purpose do you buy them for? As a fairly new stitcher, I don't know what the benefits of substitutions are. Will the results be better? That's actually a very good question. In terms of will the results be better or not, that's a matter of personal opinion. There are some designs where I want the variegation, and other designs where I don't want the variegation. So it depends a lot on the individual design and my own personal feelings about said individual design. I buy them usually because I'm wanting to go for a realistic effect or a very specific look. And I'll try to remember as I go through my whips today to sort of point that out and why I use certain things here but not there. So stick around. Lindy Muir, or Moore, but I'm assuming it's Muir, would like to know the difference between plain and opal fabric. The difference is, do I have anything that I'm doing on opal currently? I don't think so. I think all my opals are put away. Opalescent fabric has metallic threads running through it, so the fabric itself actually sparkles. And because the metallic thread doesn't generally take dye, it doesn't lose the sparkle. Whereas plain fabric is just, there's no sparkle running through it. That's really what the difference is. Kim G would like to know, do you plan on going back someday soon to any of your Soda Stitch patterns? They were looking great. Another question, well, that's the first question. She's got a couple. Yes, I do. I actually plan to restart Aladdin, once I settle on a fabric for it. But I had several other whips that I wanted to get done first before I started in on new starts again. And I think I burned myself out a little on Soda Stitch doing the two fairy tale lands with all the revisions to them. So I'm just taking a little bit of a break, but I will be going back to them because I do eventually want to finish them all. I'm also considering redoing, not the entire thing, but frogging out some stuff on Snow White, because I wasn't necessarily happy with how it turned out. But we'll see, I haven't totally made up my mind there. Then her next question was, would you ever try diamond painting? Honestly, with small, we've got a dog that gets into a lot of stuff. That looks like it needs like a flat surface to work on, and I don't really have a large flat area that I can work on continually. It's the main reason why I don't sew. I don't have a place to set it up. So probably not. I mean, it looks interesting, but I think I would probably get very bored with it. All right, Rose City Stitcher asks, how do you choose fabric for your projects? Do you purchase fabric with a project in mind? A mix of things. Sometimes it's, I decide I want to start a pattern and I have an idea of a color I want for it, and then I go through my stash and see what I've got. Other times it's, I have this project that I want to start. I don't have a fabric, so let me buy fabric specifically for it. And then other times it's, ooh, this is a really pretty fabric. Ooh, this would be perfect for this pattern that I have in my stash. Let me buy it. So it's kind of, there's not really a set way that I do things. You'll notice that about me a lot, especially if you're new to my channel. A lot of it is just sort of loosey-goosey thrown together. Cindy Maggetti, or maybe Maggetti, but I'm guessing it's Maggetti. If I ever mispronounce somebody's last name, please feel free to tell me. I completely agree. The first Halloween is definitely my favorite of the grouping. Although I will always have a little bit of a soft spot for Halloween 6, because that was actually the first one I saw. It's terrible, but I have a soft spot for it. Madam Ice asks, what do I do for rotations? Because I say every once in a while about pulling things into out of the rotation, which makes me curious about your process. So the way I do my rotation, I have, and we'll travel a little bit so you can sort of see it. I have this sort of pocket divider thing in the closet. It's got 10 pockets. So those are where my active whips go. I hope I'm not making anybody motion sick by doing this. Okay. Oop, we're back. Bloop. So those are what I classify as my active whips. They're the ones that I'm working on and are in my regular rotation. And then I have some bins, where projects that I've started but I don't really want to work on right now, or projects that I've got kitted or partially kitted, I have those there. And what I do is every month, and you'll see this here in a second, I go through my active whips, I look at the pattern, I look at where I'm at on the design, and I figure out my goal for the month. the way I determine, and then I use the Tiny Decisions app to spin the magic wheel and pick what I'm going to work on next. So when I take something out of rotation, it's because usually it's come up a couple of times on the wheel, and I just thought, no, I don't want to work on that. No, I don't want to work on that. No, I don't want to work on that. When it gets to the point that I'm thinking, I just don't want to work on it, it's time to take it out of rotation and put something else in that I might end up really being really enjoy working on. So that's kind of how I determine it. I base it, like I said, it's a little loosey-goosey. It's based a bit on my own feelings about the project at the time. So that's kind of how I handle the rotation. And then usually if I really have the urge for a new start, I'll do a new start. But sometimes I'll do the new start and then it goes away until I finish something and then I can throw it into the rotation. So that's kind of my process there. So I kind of hope that helps. I hope that sort of answers your question. If not, feel free to ask me more questions. Grace Patain has several questions. The first, how do you finish all your big pieces? I'm assuming you mean like as FFOs. The short answer is I put them in a bag in a drawer and that's kind of it. The long answer is eventually I'll get most of them framed, but since framing is expensive and wall space is a premium, a lot of things don't get framed right now. Do you know right away, and I'm guessing this ties into it, when I plan to finish, do you know right away what you will do or wait until the end to decide? Generally, I have an idea when I start it, how I want to finish it. Sometimes that changes, but that's generally how I roll with that. I do not FFO myself unless, well, it depends. Framing, new. Unless it's one where I can physically make sure that it's going to be in and nice and pretty, it gets taken to the framer at Stitch Niche. Rarely, I've only done it a few times, once when Stitch Niche didn't have a framer, actually I think that was both times, I'll have Michaels do it, but 99.9% of the time I take it to Stitch Niche. If it's a no-sew cube, I'll do that myself. If it involves sewing, it goes in a bag and it stays in there until eventually I have a way to do sewing. And if it's hoop finish, it goes in the hoop, but then it doesn't get totally finished because I don't really know how to finish off a hoop finish. So, and then finally, where do you purchase all the beautiful fabrics that you use? The bulk of my fabrics come from Ship's Manor under the Sea Fabrics. Those are the two main hand dyers I use. I got a lot of my fabric from Stitchy Box. I have occasionally will order from others. I placed an order with Color and Cotton this week. I want to try her fabrics out, so I think I ordered two pieces. Or what I find at Stitch Niche, or sometimes on de-stashing things, or where people give it to me, because they're like, hey, I bought this, I'm never gonna use it, please enjoy. So that's kind of how I determine things. So I get it from, like I said, I get things from all over the place. All right, so good Q&A. Keep it coming, y'all. I like the Q&A. All right, so first I'll show you what I worked on this week. And then I'll also discuss its goal for next month. So the first thing I did is I worked on Anniversaries of the Heart. I started it. So this is Swan Lake. I got the house outlined. I started filling in the house, which you can't quite tell. And then I worked some on the grass under it. So, my goal for next month is going to be to finish the design. Actually, we'll go ahead and put this in its frame. But this is on, Winter Brew, by R&R, with gentle arts. So that's that. Go ahead and slide you on into your thing. Weak. This is my 11 by 17 Q-snap that I use for my big projects that I hold landscape. Okay. Then I worked on Epic Disney, and I worked on Sleeping Beauty. I did Diablo and Philip. So there they are. So next time I work on this, it'll be Maleficent, Dragon Maleficent, and Castle. And that'll be in December. Because I rotate between this and Giant Harry Potter. So so here's where I'm at overall on it. Lovely. How did that even happen? That makes no sense to me. Let me reattach my needle minder. Hang on. Okay. So there's the overall. And this is on 32 Count Fairy Whispers by Die Stitch Love, which is no longer in business. Okay. Then I worked this week on Great Cheshire Moon, which is where you're going to get to see, going back to Iris Stitcher, this is going to be, you'll see a little bit of my explanation here, because I use several different specialty fibers. So this is on Silvery Moon by Ship's Manor. The design is Tempting Tangles, and I'm using a mixture of Gentle Arts wool and a little bit of Gentle Arts cotton with Ship's Manor cotton. And what I did here, you can see it on her hair a little bit and on the cat. I used the wools to give it sort of a woolly effect. You can see it here in the broom as well. The variegated, this is Cream and Sugar by Ship's Manor, this light color. Stitching it this way in the vertical gives it the effect of actual like wood planks that's aged. So it can give you a really cool, realistic effect for stuff like this. It's great for water, things like that as well. So that's one of the reasons why I will a lot of the time substitute is, and it depends some on the piece. This one was one where I really wanted that realistic look. Now we'll show you one where I didn't necessarily. Let's see, and then the next thing I'm going to work on is going to be, because I haven't worked on it yet this month, because I had to get the rest of the DMC for it, is Summer Patchwork, and I'm doing the Cherry and the Birdhouse this month, and then next month I will probably do either this grouping or this one up here. I'm not sure yet. So, but here's where I'm at on it. This one's one I'm doing in all DMC. Actually, this does show what I need. And that's because the shading in the DMC was so specific that I didn't feel like the variegation would actually do... I felt like the variegation would make it too muddy looking. So, there you go. And this is on 28 Count Yellow something. It's an even weave. So this will be what I work on next. All right, so I'll pull this open because you're gonna wanna see. Okay, so gone over those. So the next thing is going to be, here's what I'm working on in November. Now, I will also say Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee comes out mid-November, so some of this may not happen. Not gonna lie. Nope. Okay. So, on the Tammy projects, you know, I've done summer and fall, so spring and fall. So then I'm gonna do summer next. And there's the summer design. There's what it looks like. So, and that's one I will definitely work on next month. Because I would like to finish the series in December so that Christmas money can be spent taking those to Stitch Niche and having them framed. All right, so there's that. Longfellow, is gonna be the page finish, which is the woods. So the first half of the verse will be finished. And then we'll get to move on. And it's entirely possible as well that when I do move on, that I may just get into a finish binge and just finish up the entire thing in one go. I've done that before. Oh, I got a new tote bag. It says, "Let us read from the book of the prophet Carol Channing." I got it on Etsy. And the guy who sold it said that this year for Passover, he decided he would, instead of reading from the Torah, that they would read from Carol Channing's autobiography. Just lucky, I guess. Which I thought was wonderful. Okay, so then we've got my stocking, or the stocking. So next month, we're going to finish what's under this part of the bottom. So it's just some animals, you can sort of see it here. The picture's not the greatest. But there's... Wait, here, I can hold it back far enough that you can't really read the pattern. But there's a heart and a deer and a diamond and a holly berry and a tree and a diamond and a sheep and a heart and a tree and a diamond and a heart and a diamond and another deer. And then we'll just have up here just that little bit. So finish that up in December. Right. So we'll be back to Epic Harry Potter, and I will be doing on it. Nope, wrong way. So we're gonna do the last two motifs, and then looking at the top motif. My plan is going to be to do at least both of the purple leaves, but depending on how I'm doing time-wise, I may just try to finish out the outer border. Then I get to do the inner border! Yay! So exciting! So, that also means that one night here very, very soon, I need to, finish charting out something. So, going back a little bit to Irish Stitcher. So, as you can see, I've used a mix of things here. I've got some different silks that I'm using, and it's all for texture. I used Whisper Thread to give Hedwig some texture. I used a variegated thread to give the Sorting Hat more age. I'm using wool for the Quidditch sweaters. Same with up here on Ron's sweater, I used wool for texture. The hairs are all wood. So it's all about using what you've got to get the image that you're wanting. So that's kind of how I do things. Okay. Back in you go. All right. Paradise Lost. The goal is going to be a page finish. So what's left on this page to do is fill in the rest of the cloud. There's a bird, an angel, and a crown. And then this page will be done. And then I have to decide if I want to just go ahead and move on over and finish out the banner, because there's not all that much left of banner, or if I'm tired of banner, really tired of banner, and want to move on that way. So I can go one of two directions. I'm not sure which, though. But there we go. There's Paradise Lost. This is on 36 count weeks something or other. I'm not really sure what it is at this point. I'm sure if I went back to my original video, I could probably find out, but I really don't know at this point. This is a longer video than normal. All right, so on Jeanette Douglas is our common thread. I've got two motifs done, so next month's goal is just going to be the third motif. So there's where I'm at. And our third motif is this set of bookmarks here. So that'll be next. And this is on a Ship's Manor fabric of the month from, I think, January of this year. We've got the Tiny Modernist Halloween. So we've got the middle. We had part two done, so I think next time I'm gonna work on part one, which is the skeleton and the witch and the cat. So working on those. And then last but not least, we've got Thorn Castle. So I got the missing color I needed. So I will finish out this branch and I'll do the branch that's below it. So, which you can sort of kind of see. So it'll be this purpley branch here. All right, so that kind of takes care of me for the week. I hope everyone has a fantastic week, a happy Halloween if you observe Halloween. If you don't, then just have a great week. Go out and vote if you can. If not, November 6th, go vote. Yeah. So, anyhow, that's it. I will see you all next week.